Lastly, it is a real privilege for me to be here to introduce longtime friends of mine. A lot of them are fellow co-pastors of mine. Because back in the 80s, when the festival was held in Gray's Lake, my great uncle, who was also named Neil, became a Christian, largely influenced by the ministry of Resurrection Band at age 82 years old. He attended every Cornerstone from 1984 to 1991. So he actually was here on these grounds for 2 years, always a year older than whatever year it was. And his idea was that if he could make it through a Cornerstone, it meant that the warranty was good for another year. Well, he had taken ill when he was 93, and he wasn't able to be with us in 92, and he graduated and went to the bigger festival, which is where we all hope to be someday soon. But my uncle was very nervous about walking out on the stage and introducing Resurrection Band and said, a bunch of young people do not want to hear what an old man has to say. So this is what he said. Now I know that you are not here to listen to some old man up here on the stage, so let's bring out Resurrection Band so we can rock and roll.
Yeah. come and ride when we're born with a dog to dog. Please get on the car.
Change and enhance the entire Christian world. We've seen it be a groundswell for political change, for social change, for spiritual change. And this is one of these songs that just struck into my heart many, many years ago. And it's one of my very favorites. And I can sit back now and say, praise God. Justice is finally rolling down, and will it keep rolling down?
I hear the gunfire, see the blood run, feel the rage. I see a black man, see a colored man. Yeah.
When I look out, I just see so many friends. You know, this is just a little bit what it's going to be like in the New Jerusalem. This is a song I've sung many, many times. And I'm singing it for you tonight. I don't know, there might be someone here that it's their night.
Your love was right on time.
Yes.
love comes back. Oh,
couple of things. First off, this is a guitar made by J.R. McClellan. And in the last year or so here, he's been doing raffles at Cornerstone. Are they a buck a shot? I don't know what they are. They're something like that. Anyway, whatever they are, they're cheap, cheap, cheap. And he made this for me, and it blew me away. He's incredible, luthier, up in Beloit, Wisconsin. And absolutely loves Jesus. Anyway, if you're interested in a custom-made acoustic, and he will literally bug you for days if you happen to win this raffle about all the stuff you want, he'll do it for you. And all I can say is it's pretty amazing stuff. So now hopefully I won't make a fool out of JR by buffing my, messing up my partner. But anyway, this is a song that we did some years ago. And the interesting thing about it was a group effort. It had different lyrics and a lot of things got changed along the route as we recorded it. And it turned out that as we got into a high school, Rez recommended playing in a school somewhere in, I think, Ohio or somewhere, 2 weeks after the album came out. And so people met us during the sound check and just said, how did you know? And that kind of thing happens on occasion to people that are in ministry that aren't just trying to make a living. And making a living's okay, but are you hearing what I'm saying? I mean, I don't even know if the world needs another band. I think the world needs more people who love God and have the guts to believe what they say they believe. All the time. I'm trying to impress people, but genuinely. And anyway, we got into a situation where we did this song, and they knew we were coming to town and knew we'd probably play it. And a friend of theirs, almost point by point in the story, had committed suicide 2 weeks prior. I mean, the mercy and the compassion of God for people. He knows. He knows. Some guy was driving over in, I think, Sweden. A lot of money. Jaguar or something. Some major car. Flipping through the dials, decided he's going to drive right off into a fjord. Pulls over, and back in the day with telephone booths, you know, without cell phones. He called, I think it was Transworld Radio, one of the few shortwave Christian stations at that time that had the guts to play Christian rock. And they were playing this song. And he said, who is that band? And of course, God bless the guy who answered the phone. He didn't talk to him about the band. He talked to him about the point of the song. And the guy ended up meeting Jesus. So there you go. Interesting overtone, okay.
You
drifting down. I hate the night, the doom is light, but now it's holding me. Oh, baby, your baby makes me feel like I'm in a dream.
Cornerstone Festival, but it was really his brainchild in the very beginning. So give thanks to God and give him a blessing and honor to my friend and my good brother, John Harris. And man, Will Montroy on bass guitar. On the guitar, Stu Heiss. Pastor over in Lombard Bible Church. Oh man, what's the world coming to? I love this. Got to have keyboards tonight. Come on, Mike. Come on out of the background here. Mike Shelley's a good friend of ours who's, what can I tell you? He's trying to get his passport changed to Belarus, I think. He's been over there so much on mission trips. My sweetheart, Wendy Kaiser.
Yeah, well, this is Glenn. You know, I have a kind of little funny story to tell. My grandchildren have never seen Resurrection Band. And when we were doing the box set and we were getting the DVD ready from the 20 Years Live concert, I had the rough cuts, and I brought it home and I played it, and my grandsons were in the room and they started screaming and yelling and running out of the room and hiding their faces, and they were beside themselves and they said, "Who is that weird lady with your voice coming out?" And it took them about 3 or 4 times watching it before they could kind of look at me and think, "What kind of person are you? You have a secret life, kind of like Spy Kids, you know." But I have the wonderful joy of having my grandchildren here. One of them is right back there, bouncing around, hurting themselves, and being very happy. And And isn't family great?
Don't you want somebody to love? Don't you? Yeah.
Stay tuned for the 77. Thank you.
This is for all my young fans that are 10 and under, and I hope you'll sing along with me, especially Junie and Pearl and Mia.
Come on!
Thank you.